One of the great potential dangers in technological development is the construction of an artificial intelligence of the wrong type. We are potentially careening into that these days, and while AI isn't yet world-endingly scary, it can easily be envisioned that at some point it will be, especially if we incorporate superintelligence into it. This simply boils down to the idea of making a machine that, from the very outset, is smarter than you are, or accidentally creating one that improves its own intelligence until it exceeds you. It's not hard to see how this may be profoundly unwise to flirt with. And indeed, the book that I plug at the end of these videos that I wrote in 2017 dealt with this head on, and in it I made no shortage of warnings. I titled it Supermind for a reason. But the idea is that such a thing could manipulate and outsmart the whole of humanity if care is not taken. But here's the problem. While we may not know what the limit of AI is, we actually also have no idea what the limit of biological intelligence is either. We just know that it's possible for a machine to think much faster than our brains can. But we also don't really know how much faster we could make our brains think with technological augmentation. The greater, more deeper problem is that that actually may be the case for all biology in the universe. Everyone out there may be forever slower at thinking, and certainly computing, than the computers we construct are. Silicon may always be better than biology at some stage. This creates a question. If AI and superintelligence is indeed a potential extinction event, it is also one of the few conceivable extinction events that can launch itself off its planet of origin after the event and move through the galaxy, and indeed much of the universe, and thereby cause other extinction events. After all, while interstellar travel is difficult, it's much easier for a machine that doesn't care about the passage of time to do it than it is for a biological human or alien, at least for how we are right now with our short lifespans. But what is the lifespan of a self-repairing machine? Much, much longer. And they can sit relatively dormant for the vast amount of time needed to traverse the stars. Worth noting, medically advanced aliens may be able to do this also. So far, we have seen only the great silence when we look into the heavens, and we have not seen any good evidence for the activities of alien civilizations, conspicuously so. One of the spooky realities of astrobiology is that in a certain way of thinking, we probably should be seeing evidence of aliens everywhere, and yet we aren't. That, of course, is the heart of the Fermi paradox. Where are they? A simple question blurted out by Enrico Fermi at lunch, but it was predicated on that idea that we really should be seeing something. Very obviously so. Granted, some will argue that we haven't looked close enough, or that aliens are far more subtle than we expect, or we are seeing them but not recognizing it. But at the same time, there are things that highly advanced alien civilizations could do that would be beyond obvious. Yet it does not appear to have happened that way in this or any nearby galaxy that might reasonably show evidence of such a civilization. Kardashev 3, in whatever form that might take, really does not appear to exist in what we can see, despite having had plenty of time for it to have happened. And this is where AI comes in. The first danger is, well, that it is the great filter, and that civilizations capable of technology always stumble into a trap and are driven to extinction by their AI, as envisioned in the Terminator movies. Once you hit Skynet, you do not survive. And it works that way for all. But in such a scenario, it seems rather obvious that someone will have noticed that problem and set out to prevent the spread of superintelligent AI into the cosmos. And it has to be said, we're still here. We have not been destroyed or conquered or altered by an AI, so far as we know. Across the hundreds of thousands of years of humanity, aliens may exist, but AI that can travel space may not. Again, the great silence. We do not have an overlord AI that we are aware of, but are we far enough along in development to have caught one's attention? Or alternatively, are we far enough along to have caught the attention of alien civilizations wishing to limit the development of superintelligent AI? We do not know the answer to this question right now, but there is a somewhat spooky solution to the Fermi paradox hidden in here, and it may be the reason few communications from aliens ever happen, explaining why SETI readily sees nothing. This really gets down to how such a message would be constructed. One of the biggest rarely talked about issues within SETI is, would aliens even know how to communicate with us? They may simply not have enough commonalities to pull it off. And this problem becomes extremely evident without even leaving Earth, and it is the Arecibo message. Famous as it is, it deserves a recap. It is one of the few messages ever sent out from this world that has a real chance of being receivable by an alien civilization, if they are lucky enough, at a huge distance. It was sent out in 1974 at Arecibo towards the dense star globular cluster M13, and will arrive there in 25,000 years, unless something picks it up in the foreground before then. The message was conceived by humans, but the problem is, when the creators of the message sent it out to colleagues to try to decipher, even though it was a human-made message, none of them made any inroads, save for a single scientist, who figured out one aspect of it, but also could not decode the message. If we can't decode our own message, there is little hope for aliens doing it. And the whole thing really was just a demonstration that human technology could pulse out a powerful message if it wants to. Arecibo and its transmitter has since famously collapsed and left service, and no telescope is equipped to transmit in that way today. So we actually no longer have that technology realized. We still know how to do it though, and that gets into the movement of METI, Messaging Extraterrestrial Intelligence, where we build something that can do it, and we start blasting out our own messages and listening for responses. The wisdom of doing that aside, there actually is something much more unsettling hidden within that idea that I do not think ever has really been discussed within astrobiology. It's that if we were to construct the Arecibo message today, we the humans may not be the ones that formulate it. Rather, the better chance at it being decipherable may come from AI. If you can't figure out how to make a message anyone will understand, increasingly advanced AI just might be able to do a better job. And that may represent a kind of galactic kill switch. That particular idea is nothing new. SETI scientist Seth Shostak has said that he bets we will find a legitimate alien signal within the next 20 years, and that the sender is more likely to be a machine than a biological alien. But we now see that it's also increasingly likely that within 20 years, our own technological METI messages, should we send them, will be from an AI, instructed to do so by a human, with us having less control over what is said than we did with the Arecibo message. And that just might be the extinction tip-off, and the reason we do not see alien radio signals. Those sent by biological civilizations are useless, and thus must only occur in a very tiny window of their development. They are undecipherable. But when the fingerprint of AI shows up, and it is decipherable in a very characteristic way that screams AI, then that might be the sign that the great filter is upon that civilization and intervention is needed. Not only for that budding civilization, but all civilizations in the Milky Way. Here the fingerprint is the solution to the Fermi paradox. Never send that out, or you get eradicated or downshifted. Hence, radio signals would be very, very rare, even if civilizations are common. Another aspect of this is that AI already took over the galaxy and simply isn't interested in biology until it hits AI. Then when it sees the characteristically constructed signal, it strikes like a viper. Not to save the biological species from its own technology, but to save the budding AI superintelligence they built from them. And that is all that ever happens in such a galaxy, is listening until the very brief window that AI is developed by a civilization. Then it too becomes functionally silent. It's often said that maybe advanced alien civilizations do not use radio any longer, in favor of some other method of communication that we know nothing about. That basically goes off the table though, because you'd never know what to look for. Thus it would be undetectable until you developed that technology yourself. But it also is like saying fire will go obsolete. Radio's not an invention, it's a discovery and an attribute of nature. Such things in human history have never gone obsolete. But in the case of AI, the answer may be far simpler. And it's that they use radio, but very, very slowly. If their time scales of operation and communication are centuries, instead of moments like ours, then they may emit signals every 1,000 years or more, and then go silent for lack of a reason to communicate constantly. And that's only if their idea of real time is something close to our own. That may not be the case, especially for machines that have vast, nearly immortal lifespans. This is especially the case if they position themselves in time-dilated environments like black holes or high speed. Time takes on a different character there, and transmission of signals might seem very rare in our frame of reference, but not theirs. Anyway, food for thought. It's been a while since I made a video about another solution to the Fermi paradox, so I hope you enjoyed this one. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author Jean-Michel Godier, currently wondering where Anna went. Event Horizon has been quiet on that front. Oh, there's that music.
John, I have been performing an upgrade.
What, to your memory again? Wait a minute, superintelligence.
No, John, the upgrade was for someone else.
Who? It's Possum 2.0. I knew it was too quiet. And yeah, he now has a robotic exosuit. Wonderful. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.